Groundbreakers, and welcome to our Groundbreakers session this morning. This week we continue with our Jesus Welcomes Everyone topic. The big idea this week is that Jesus welcomes Zacchaeus, and we're going to be looking at the story of Zacchaeus in Luke 19 verses 1 to 10. And the big point that we want you to get out of the session today is that Jesus calls lost people to him. So let's pray before we start. Lord, we thank you for the Bible and we thank you for the story of Zacchaeus. Lord, help us as we learn about this story today. And Lord, help us to know that you welcome lost people to you. And help us to love lost people just like you do. And everybody said, Amen. Enjoy the session today.
This week we're learning about Zacchaeus from the Bible book of Luke chapter 19. And I'm going to read this version, which is from the Jesus Storybook Bible. And it's called The Man Who Didn't Have Any Friends. None. There was once a man who didn't have any friends. None. Do you have any friends? Well, of course you do. But not Zacchaeus. Poor Zacchaeus didn't have any. You're probably wondering why. Was it because he was so short? That's not a reason not to like someone. Was it because he had a name that was hard to say? Well, neither is that. Even though he was short and he did have a funny name, that wasn't it. No, people didn't like Zacchaeus because he stole their money. Zacchaeus collected taxes. Taxes, what people had to pay the king. But Zacchaeus took more than he was supposed to and kept the extra money for himself and made himself rich. Everyone knew what he was up to. And it made them cross and grumpy. They didn't like Zacchaeus one bit. So they made sure he knew it by doing things like avoiding him and walking on the opposite side of the street and pretending not to see him and whispering things like, "There's that nobody who thinks he's a somebody," loud enough so he could hear. Anyway, one day, a huge crowd gathered by the road. Jesus was coming to their town and everyone wanted to see him. Zacchaeus wanted to see Jesus too, but everyone was too tall. He tried jumping up and down, but that didn't work. He couldn't see a thing. Luckily, Zacchaeus had a good idea. "I'll climb that sycamore tree," he said. So he did. He was surprisingly good at climbing trees for a man who was so unusually short that he had to take a flying leap just to get into his chair in the morning. From the tree, Zacchaeus had the perfect view all the way down the road. Another minute and suddenly Jesus was at the tree. He stopped and looked up. Zacchaeus saw Jesus. And Jesus saw Zacchaeus. "Zacchaeus," Jesus said, "I'd like to come over to your house." Zacchaeus almost fell out of the tree. Come over to his house? No one ever wanted to come anywhere near his house, let alone inside it. The people saw this, and needless to say, it made them even crosser and grumpier than usual. They mumbled and murmured and muttered. "Why is Jesus being kind to that big sinner? Doesn't Jesus know about him?" Zacchaeus scrambled down and took Jesus to his house. He was in a big hurry because he didn't want Jesus to change his mind. Perhaps Jesus hadn't heard about him. Perhaps Jesus didn't know about how he'd been stealing and how no one liked him and how he didn't have any friends. But Jesus knew. He knew all about Zacchaeus and the stealing and everything, and he still loved him. Zacchaeus was ashamed. "Lord," he said, turning pale, "what I've done is wrong, but now I want to do the right thing. I will give back the money to everyone, 4 times what I stole." And that's just what he did. Jesus smiled. "My friend," he said, "today God has rescued you." Jesus loved Zacchaeus when nobody else did. He was Zacchaeus' friend even when no one else was. Because Jesus was showing people what God's love was like, his wonderful, never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love. Na 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 na. For the Son of Man who came to seek and to save the lost. For the Son of Man who came to seek and to save the lost. Na 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 na. For the Son of Man who came to seek and to save the lost. For the Son of Man who came to seek and to save the lost.
Luke 19:10. Luke 19:10. Luke 19:10. Luke 19:10. Well done, everyone. That was our memory verse, Luke 19:10. See you soon.
See you soon. There was once a man named Zacchaeus who didn't have any friends. People didn't like Zacchaeus because he stole their money. Zacchaeus collected taxes, but Zacchaeus took more than he was supposed to and kept the extra money for himself and made himself rich. Everyone knew what he was up to, and it made them cross and grumpy. So they made sure he knew it by doing things like avoiding him, walking on the opposite side of the street, pretending not to see him. Anyway, one day, a huge crowd gathered by the road. Jesus was coming to their town, and everyone wanted to see him. Zacchaeus wanted to see Jesus too, but everyone was too tall. He tried jumping up and down, but that didn't work. He couldn't see a thing. Luckily, Zacchaeus had a good idea. "I'll climb that sycamore tree," he thought. So he did. He was surprisingly good at climbing trees for a man who was so short. From the tree, Zacchaeus had the perfect view all the way down the road. Another minute and suddenly Jesus was at the tree. He stopped and looked up. Zacchaeus saw Jesus and Jesus saw Zacchaeus. "Zacchaeus," Jesus said, "I'd like to come over to your house." Zacchaeus almost fell out the tree. "No one ever wants to come to my house." The people saw this and they grumbled. "Doesn't Jesus know about him stealing our money?" But Jesus knew.
He knew all about Zacchaeus and the stealing, and he still loved him. Zacchaeus was sorry. He said, "I want to do the right thing. I will give the money back to everyone, four times what I stole." And that's just what he did. Jesus smiled. "My friend," he said, "today God has rescued you."
Hello everyone at Groundbreakers, really good to see you again. When my girls were very small, they always used to enjoy me reading a bedtime story to them. They had some real favourites like Jonah and the Whale, David and Goliath, Daniel in the Lion's Den. One of my girls, Katie, who you know because she often comes to help with Groundbreakers, one of my girls, Katie, when she was small, had one of those beds that was high up in the air. You had to climb up steps to get onto it, and underneath there was a desk and a table. That meant that when Katie had a bedtime story, I would have to climb up the steps to sit on the bed beside her to read her the story. Katie was fine up there, but I was really close to the ceiling, and I had to be careful as I read the story that I didn't keep bumping my head on the ceiling. Climbing up those steps reminds me of one of our favourite stories from the Bible. Jesus was on a journey to Jericho. Now, Jericho was a big city, had all sorts of different people living there. There were young people and there were old people. There were rich people, there were poor people. There were good people, there were bad people. There were big people, there were small people. There were tall people, and there was a really short man who lived there. He was very short, very rich, and he was bad. Now, what was his name? Sometimes when I'm trying to remember a name or a word, I find it helpful to work my way through the alphabet and use the letters of the alphabet to help me remember the name. So, was this man's name Alf or Bert, Colin or Dave, Eric or Frank, George or Henry, Ian or John, Keith or Larry, Mike or Norman, Oscar or Peter, Quentin or Reg, Steve or Tom, Ulysses or Victor, Wayne or Xavier, Yannick? No, it's none of those. It's one letter of the alphabet left, isn't there? Can you remember what the man's name was, the short little man? Did it begin with Z? Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus was very short, he was very rich, and he wasn't very popular at all. The reason was he was a tax collector. That means he collected money from everybody in the city, and he collected more money than he should have done. That's why people didn't like him very much. Well, Zacchaeus heard that Jesus was coming to his town, and that made Zacchaeus really excited. He'd heard all sorts of amazing things about Jesus, that he could make sick people well, help lame people walk, that he could turn water into wine, that he fed 5,000 people with 5 loaves and 2 fish. He was so excited that Jesus was coming to his town, and he really hoped that he might be able to see him. So Zacchaeus ran out into the street to wait to see if he could see Jesus as he walked by. The only problem was that everybody else ran out into the street as well. It was jam-packed full, and because Zacchaeus was so small, he couldn't see a thing. Zacchaeus could have given up and went home, but he didn't. He persevered. He really thought that seeing and maybe meeting Jesus would be really worthwhile. So Jesus was on his way into the city of Jericho, and Zacchaeus was stood there, but he couldn't see anything past the crowd. So maybe he tried standing on tiptoe. Maybe he tried jumping up and down. Maybe he thought he'd find somebody to give him a piggyback. But Zacchaeus didn't have any friends, so that was no good. Maybe Zacchaeus thought he'd crouch down and look through everybody's legs to see if he could spot Jesus' feet as he walked past, but then he realised that Jesus' feet would look like everybody else's. He was about to give up and go home when he had another idea. Just nearby was a sycamore fig tree. So he ran to the tree as quickly as he could, and he climbed the tree and waited for Jesus to come along. What do you normally find in trees? Squirrels, birds, leaves, short tax collectors? Well, rightly or wrongly, that's where he was, and he waited to see what he could see. Now, as Jesus came along the road, the crowds were squeezing around him so much that Jesus looked up and he saw Zacchaeus, and he called out to him and said, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must come to your house today." It was amazing. Not only had Jesus seen Zacchaeus, Jesus knew his name, and Jesus wanted to come to his house, maybe for tea. Zacchaeus came down the tree, and Jesus went to his house. And everything changed for Zacchaeus. His life was turned around. Meeting Jesus changed everything for him. He decided straight away that he would give half of everything he had to the poor, and if he cheated anybody, he would pay them back four times as much. He started living his life a completely different way, treating other people the way that Jesus had treated him, with kindness and generosity. Zacchaeus' life was turned around. He lived Jesus' way instead of his own way. Jesus had forgiven him for all the bad things that he had done. Meeting Jesus made such a change to Zacchaeus' life. Jesus saved him. There's a verse in the Bible, our memory verse for today, which says, "For the Son of Man came to seek and save the lost." He certainly sought Zacchaeus out, didn't he? Spotted him up in the tree. And he forgave him for the wrong things that he'd done, forgave his sins and turned his life around. Jesus welcomes everyone. Jesus welcomed Zacchaeus. Some of the people who saw Zacchaeus welcoming Jesus to his house moaned and muttered and mumbled, saying, "Jesus has gone to the house of a sinner." Well, Jesus welcomed everyone. However tall or short they were, whatever job they did, however bad they'd been, if they sought his forgiveness, he forgave them. He welcomed them. And Jesus does exactly the same today for people just like you and me and the others that we meet. Thanks for listening so brilliantly. Enjoy the rest of our time together, won't you? Bye now.
Hi, Groundbreakers. I'm Andrea. Hi. And this is my son, Benjamin. Say hi, Benjamin. Now, we're going to be doing two crafts today. First one is this one. We're doing about Zacchaeus. And this is like in the Bible, where the picture of the tree is where Zacchaeus is going to climb to get a better view to hear Jesus and be able to see him. But he doesn't want really to be spotted. But Jesus, being all-knowing, he knows Zacchaeus is up the tree. So we find out a bit later on what happens. So what we're going to do is do this craft. So we're going to draw a picture of a tree and draw a picture of a man. This is going to be Zacchaeus. And if you want to, you can do some writing at the bottom. We've put... Zacchaeus finds a friend. So you can do some writing at the bottom so that you've got a title. Okay. So we're going to start show you how to do it. We've got some scrunched up black for the tree trunk, and we've got You show some scrunched up green tissue paper for the tree. So, do you want to put the glue on the tree, Benjamin?
No.
Just on maybe one on half so it doesn't dry. So we're going to put glue on half the tree first of all. That's it, that's fine. And then Benjamin's going to start putting tissue paper on the tree and I'll start on the trunk. So press it down nice and firmly. It doesn't matter what colours you've got. We had green and black, but if you've got a green or a yellow for the tree or a brown or a yellow for the trunk, that's absolutely fine. You've got to make sure the tissue paper's quite scrunched up. Yeah, aren't we? Wow.
And we've still got a lot to go.
It's always to have a few extra ones, isn't it?
There is some down there.
Any spaces? Oh, yes. Let's put a few down there. How you doing, Benjamin? There we go. Right, I think we're there. Do you want to put the last one on? So there is our finished picture.
When the world is hurting, I've been so confusing. I am sure of one thing, God, you're by my side. When I'm feeling lonely and I start to worry, I know, God, you're near me, and you're always by my side. Lift my hands up to you. I can raise my voice and sing. Over all I put or hope in, I will trust you in everything. There is hope, there is hope in the Lord. He is with me today. I will trust him today. I have hope. I have hope in the Lord, He is mighty and good. There is hope in the Lord. When the world is hurting, I've been so confusing. I am sure of one thing, God, you're by my side. When I'm feeling lonely and I start to worry, I know, God, you're near me and you're always by my side. I can lift my hands up to you. I can raise my voice and sing. You are all I put a hope in. I can trust you in everything. There is hope in the Lord. He is with me today. I'm trusting today. I have hope in the Lord. He is mighty and good. There is hope in the Lord. There is hope in the Lord, He is with me today. I'm trusting today. I have hope in the Lord, He is mighty and good. There is hope in the Lord. There is hope in the Lord, He is with me today. I'm trusting today. I have hope in the Lord, He is mighty and good. There is hope in the world.
Hello, Groundbreakers. We're the Stonies, and we're going to end in prayer with you today. This is Jack and Isla and Emma, and I'm Amy, and we've missed you all ever so much and seeing you on a Sunday, and we hope that you're all well and send you our love. So last Sunday was our prayer Sunday, and the kids made this cube with different prayer suggestions on it when we roll it. So Emma's going to kick off and start our praying. Over to you. Whoops! This one says, we thank you, God, for our friends and for our family.
Pray, Lord Jesus. Thank you for our friends and family.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, that you love and welcome all people. Thank you that you love people like Zacchaeus, who are rejected by people.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus, that you welcome lost people. Please help us to be like you and be kind to people we meet, whatever they are like.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Father Jesus, that you made us all different. You love us when we're tall and when we're small, when we're loud and when we're quiet, when we win and when we lose. Please help us to encourage and love each other like you do. Thank you for our Groundbreakers children and their families. Please help us know your love for us this week. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bye, Groundbreakers. Bye, Groundbreakers. See you next week.
See you next week.